Hello and welcome back. Today I have taken another example and to diagonalize that matrix. So here is the question 2. The question is diagonalize the matrix. So it's a 2x2 matrix. So you have to diagonalize this matrix. So this type of questions may be come in your exam. So let's do it. I think you know from my previous video how to diagonalize matrix, but I just want to repeat the same concept by taking another example. So because I think the number of times you will solve more examples, number of times you solve the examples, it's going, you will have a grip over the concept. So here is the what we have to first do. So this is the solutions procedure. So first thing you have to find the, so step one, in step one, so if I write it as a steps. So in step one, what you have to do, you have to find the eigenvalues of the matrix A. So first in step one, find all the eigenvalues of the matrix A. So this is your first step. So now to find eigenvalue of the matrix, what we have to do, we have to find the determinant of the matrix A minus lambda into identity matrix. And what we're going to do, if after this determinants we will get an equation. So if I is equals to 0, so this gives us, so let me write them down, so we get 3 minus lambda 1 0 1 minus lambda, and this have to be equal with 0. So from there what we get, so if I calculate the determinants, we'll get 3 minus lambda into 1 minus lambda, which is equals to 0. So this is polynomial equations. So from there what we get, so we get either the value of lambda is 3, so either, let me write, either 3 minus lambda, which is equals to 0, so this implies lambda is 3, so 3 is one of our eigenvalue, or 1 minus lambda equals to 0, so from there we get lambda equals to 1. So we know that the possible number of solutions, so all possible solutions of the polynomial equation, determinant of A minus lambda equals to 0, are the eigenvalues of the matrix A. So eigenvalues, the eigenvalues of A are eigenvalues of A are 3 and 1, or just let me write 1 and 3. So these are our two eigenvalues for the given matrix A. So this is our step 1. So let me erase this step 1. I think you have understand the step 1. So let me erase this step 1. So from step 1 we get two eigenvalues, 1 and 3. So let me erase this part and let it write over here. So from step 1 we get the eigenvalues, the lambda, which is either 1 or 3. So what we have to do in step 2? In step 2 you have to find the eigenvectors corresponding to the eigenvalues 1 and 3. So corresponding to the eigenvalues 1 and 3, find the eigenvectors. So first find the eigenvector corresponding to the eigenvalue 1. So first task is to find eigenvector corresponding to the eigenvalue lambda equals to 1. This is our first task. So what we have to do, we have to do in this way. Suppose that x is our eigenvector, so we assume that, So x is our eigenvector. Then what we have? Then ax have to be equals to lambda into x. Here lambda is 1. So what we get? We get a into 1 x, which is 1 into x. So suppose let me assume that x is, so we assuming x is our eigenvector. So assuming x is one of that eigenvectors corresponding to the eigenvalue 1, assuming that x is because we are talking about a 2 by 2 matrix, so eigenvector will be a vector from R2, and so x is something like x1 and x2, so it's a 2 by 1 matrix. So from there what we get, so put the value of a, so we get 3, 1, 0, 1 into we get x1 x2 which have to be equal with x1, x2. From there what we get, so if I multiply these two matrix, from that matrix multiplication we get 3x1 plus x2 and 0x1 plus x2, so we get x2 which is equals to the right hand side x1 and x2. So from there you can see that this quantity and this quantity are same, and because these two vectors same, this quantity have to be equals with this quantity. So from there we get the equation. So what equation we get? We get 3x1 plus x2 have to be equal with x1. So from there what we get? So we get x2 equal to, from there we get x2 equals to minus 2x1. So this is the criteria that the second quantity of the vector x2 is the minus 2 into the first quantity, which is x1. So let me write down the solution space or solution space for this equation. So let me erase this first. So what we get? Solution space, or just let me write down the eigenvector. So possible all type of eigenvectors. So all eigenvectors are, so all, let me write down all eigenvectors corresponding to the eigenvalue, all eigenvectors of A corresponding to the eigenvalue 1 corresponding to 1 is of the form, so is of the form. So all the eigenvectors corresponding to 1 is of the form that it have to be equals to x1, x2, or if I put the value which is equals to here, x2 is minus 2x1. So we get x1 and here we minus 2x1. So from there, if I put, if I take outside x1, so we get x1 into 1 minus 2. So now who are the eigenvectors corresponding to 1? So if I put defined value of x1, we get defined eigenvectors. Obviously x1, we are taking x1 is non-zero, and x1 is any real number. So defined value of different real numbers, we get different eigenvectors corresponding to the eigenvalue 1. So we get infinite number of eigenvectors. But the main thing over here, the thing you have to observe, that all eigenvectors is of the form that, so here you can see it clearly that all eigenvectors, so all eigenvectors is, if I, this is x1 is any real number, we can put any real number. Obviously we do not want to put x0, we want to put any non-zero real number, then we will get any eigenvectors corresponding to 1. But the main thing is x1 is a scalar and this is our vector. So all the eigenvectors are the linear combination of this vector 1 minus 2. So constant into vector, so this is a linear combination of this vector. So all eigenvectors is of this form. So all eigenvectors are linear combination of this vector. So what we're going to have, so all the vectors, instead of taking infinite number of vectors, what we're going to do, we'll take x1 equals to 1 and we take only our eigenvectors. So we will take eigenvectors, one of our eigenvectors corresponding to 1 is 1 comma minus 2. You don't have to take another eigenvectors corresponding to 1. Why? Because all eigenvectors going to be linear combination of this vector, so constant scaling of this vector, so all vector are going to be linearly, all vectors are basically depend on these vectors, depend in the sense that we can write a multiplication, so all other eigenvectors, so all other eigenvectors, if I take any eigenvector, suppose we are taking x1 is one of our eigenvector, then that is can be written as a constant. So suppose this is a constant into 1 minus 2, you can see that. So because all eigenvector is of this form, so if we take another eigenvector which is x1, which is capital x1, which is constant into this vector, so if I'm from there, you can easily see that, and k is obviously non-zero quantity, so this vector is depend on this vector. Why? We can write it in this way, x1 plus minus k into 1 minus 2, which is equals to 0. So here we have a non-zero quantity, here also we have a non-zero quantity, and combination of these two vectors is equals to 0. So these two vectors are linearly dependent, so x1 is depend on these vectors, so that's why we do not take another vectors, we only take this is as our eigenvectors corresponding to lambda equals to 1. I think you understand that first. If you not, just pause the video and repeat over and over again. I think you can clearly understand the thing what I am saying over here. So let me erase this part. So we have find that out. So in step 2 we have find out that one of our eigenvectors one of our eigenvectors corresponding to lambda equals to 1 is lambda equals to 1 is 1 comma minus 2. So let me write that down. So we get 1 comma minus 2 because all other eigenvectors corresponding to lambda equals to 1 are linearly dependent, and it's is we can write that by a constant and to these vectors. So we only have to take this vector, do not take another vectors same type. So now again we have to find the eigenvector. Now we're going to find the eigenvector corresponding to the eigenvalue. So eigenvector corresponding to the eigenvector eigenvalue 5 corresponding to eigenvalue 5. So what we have to do, we have to do the same thing over again. So we have some x into a vector y which is 5 into y. So y, suppose we assuming that y is our y1, y2. So from there what we get, put that value of a and y. So we get a is 3 comma 1, 0 comma 1 into y1 y2 which is equals to 5 into y1 y2. So from there we can write 5 into y1 5 y2, so 5 y1 and 5 y2. So from there we can write and dot on that way. So what we have to do, I have to do, so multiply these two sides of the equation. So multiply both the matrix A with this matrix. So from there what we get, so we get, just a minute, I have to do one of the official work. So just I is taking 1 second. So from there what we get, just a minute. So I have to multiply the equation. So we get 3y1 plus y2, and here you get y2, which is equals to 5y1 and y2. So 5y1, 5y2. So from there, what we can get, we have this quantity is have to be equals with this quantity have to be equals with this quantity. So we can write that down from there. So we get the two equations. So I'm just taking your time, I'm sorry for that, but let me do, otherwise I will be distracted. So here we get 3y1 plus y2, which is 5 into y1, so 5y1, and this is our equation 1. And another equation is just 1 second. So from there, so from the second quantity we get y2 equals to 5y2. So from there, so let me write that down. I have done my official work, now I can do it to solve this in the last part. So here we go. So from there, from equation 2, you can see that from equation 2 we get 4y2 equals to 0. That implies that y2 have to be equals to 0. And from 1, what we get from 1, we get 3y1 plus y2 is 0 over here, and which is equals to 5y1. So what we get, 2y1, which is equals to 0. So y1 is 0 over here. Do I make some mistakes? Otherwise both of them are equals to 0. How could this be possible? Oh, I made a mistake over here. So here I've taken lambda as a 5, not it's have to be eigenvalue corresponding to lambda equals to 3. So I made mistakes over there. So I'm sorry for that. I have to do it again. I was distracted by one of the message given by my authority. So here we have a into y equals to v 3 into y. So from there we get 3 into 1, 0 into 1. So from there, and here we have y1 and y2, which is equals to. So you may ask, how do I understand that I am wrong somewhere else and getting the problems? I will, at the end of the video, I will say to you why I have just sense or taste that there must be a problem. So we get 3y1 plus y2, and y2 equals to 3 into y1 and 3y2 from these two equations. So this implies this quantity have to be equals to this quantity have to be equal to this quantity. So from there, what we get, 3y1 plus y2 equals to 3y1. So from there, if 3y1 3y1 will be cancel out, and from there we get y2 equals to 0. And from second equation you also get 3y1 equals to y2. So this also implied that y2 have to be equals to 0. So y2 is 0 is 1. So from there, what we get, so from these two we get that eigenvalue will be, so our eigenvalue is, so I think my eigenvalue is, so eigenvector, so not eigenvalue, so eigenvector, all possible eigenvectors corresponding to the eigenvalue 5 is of the form y1 y2, which is equal to going to have it gives us so what is y1? Y1 is any numbers and y2 is 0. So y1 into 0. So from there, if I just take outside y1, so we get 1, 0. So you can see that all eigenvectors is of the form y1 into 1, 0. So what is y1? Y1 is any real number, and because we are talking about eigenvector, we do not want to take y1 as 0. So y1 can be taken as any real number. So y1 is any real number. Y1 can be 1.5, 1, 1. Y1 can be 2, y1 can be -5, y1 can be anything, any real number except the real number 0. So this is one of our eigenvectors, and all eigenvectors is a multiplication of one of the eigenvectors. So you can see that is a multiplication of the eigenvectors 1, 0. So what we're going to do, we will take corresponding to lambda equals to 5. We only take that our 1, 0. So how we get the 1, 0? When we put y1 equals to 1, we will get the eigenvector 1, 0. We will take 1, 0 as our eigenvector, one of the eigenvector corresponding to the eigenvalue 5, because all other eigenvectors will be a linear combination of this vector, because you can see here we have a constants and into vector. So all eigenvectors are multiplications by a scalar and in this form. So we only take 1, 0 as our eigenvectors. All eigenvectors are more depends on these vectors basically, so we will not take others as our eigenvectors. So we get basically two eigenvectors cos of the matrix A. So what we get for from step 2, we get corresponding to 1, we get the eigenvector 1, -2, and from corresponding to the eigenvalue, so corresponding to the eigenvalue 5, we get our eigenvector 1, 0. So there are two eigenvectors. So here we have 2 by 2 matrix, and we get two different eigenvectors. Do this eigenvector. So in step 3, what you have to do, you have to check that these two eigenvectors are linearly dependent or independent. So what we're going to do, we find the modal matrix. So modal matrix, if I we can write some as a modal matrix if the determinant of the matrix is non-zero. So first check the determinants of the matrix corresponding to the eigenvector. So first I take 1, 0, and second I take 1, -2. So from there, if I find the determinant of these two, determinant of this matrix, you can clearly see this will be -2, which is non-zero. So this vector and this vector are linearly independent, so we can form a modal matrix. So modal matrix, we write the modal matrix as P. So here, which is 1, 0 and 1, -2. So this is our modal matrix, or the matrix by which A will be diagonalized, and in matrix has an inverse. So this is our modal matrix. So from there we can write that A is a diagonalizable matrix. So A is the given A is a diagonalizable matrix, diagonalizable matrix. So from there, because the matrix P, we can find the modal matrix, and because we can find the determinant of the matrix and which is non-zero, so we can find the modal matrix, means the P has an inverse, so is diagonalizable. So the matrix to which A is diagonalizable is, so you know that the diagonal matrix to which A will be diagonalizable. So first let me erase this part. So the matrix to which A is diagonalizable is the diagonal matrix. So that's how you have to find, you have to diagonalize the matrix. So diagonal matrix to which A is similar is the matrix will be the principal diagonal entry with corresponding to the first diagonal entry k will come from the corresponding to the eigenvector 1 0. So with respect to eigenvector 1 0, we get the eigenvalue 5, so it will be 5 0 0, and corresponding to the eigenvector 1 minus 2, we get the eigenvalue 1. So that's what's not 5 again. I made a mistake. That was 3 actually. So that was 3. 3, 0, 0, and 1. So I'm sorry, a number of time I made a mistake because of some distraction. So I'm sorry for that. I think you understand the whole thing. So here is the modal matrix. So if we change the modal matrix, suppose I take another modal matrix in this form, that first column of the matrix is our eigenvector 1 minus 2, and second is 1 0. So they will came from they have come from the eigenvectors 1 minus 2 1 0. Then on that case, the diagonal matrix will be to which is similar will be first principal diagonal entries. In the principal diagonal entries, we have a quantity, first entry come from this eigenvector. So here we get the 1 is the eigenvalue corresponding to this eigenvectors, and 0 0 and corresponding to this eigenvector eigenvalue is 5. So it's again not 5, 3. Yeah, why am I writing number of time is 5? So it's 3 basically. So 1 0 0 3 is our eigen pair. Now this is the diagonal matrix to which the given matrix A is similar. So I think you understand the whole process of diagonalize a matrix. Now I just want to reveal, so how can we say that goes wrong in somewhere when doing the calculations. The thing is, the actually there is a results from there, you can say that. So result says that, so here is the results what I am now going to state for you. From there you can say that, so but the results is says that. So result says that, so here is the results says that let A be a n by n matrix, maybe diagonal A by n matrix. Not I am saying that this have to be diagonalized at first. So A is a n by n matrix. If we get n distinct eigenvalues, eigenvalues of A, so for example, then all the eigenvectors corresponding eigenvectors, so then all the corresponding eigenvectors, then all the corresponding eigenvectors, all the corresponding eigenvectors, corresponding eigenvector will be corresponding eigenvectors are linearly independent. So linearly independent. So first of all, we will obviously get an eigenvectors corresponding to each eigenvalue, and all eigenvectors are linearly independent. So for example, if we have a matrix A and we get the eigenvalue lambda 1, lambda 2 and lambda n, and all are different. So lambda 1 not equals to lambda 2 not equals to, so all are distinct. So what we get, so corresponding to lambda 1, suppose we get the eigenvector x1, corresponding to the lambda 2 we get eigenvector x2, and corresponding to lambda n we get the eigenvector xn. Then it says that x1, x2, xn are all will be linearly independent. So x1, x2, xn are all linearly independent. So they are all linearly independent. So because we have a n by n matrix and we get the n linearly independent eigenvectors, so matrix must be diagonalizable. So this is from here. So from the matrix, so matrix So A must be diagonalizable. So that's the clear from here, from this statement. So from the last example, we have a matrix A, which was, I think it's 3 1 0 1, and from there we get eigenvalues 1 and 3. So we get two distinct eigenvalue, and we have a 2 by 2 matrix. So corresponding to 1, obviously we'll get an eigenvectors, and suppose which we get, which is x1, and corresponding to 3 we'll get another eigenvectors, and we know that these two eigenvectors have to be linearly independent to each other. So somehow when calculating the second one, we are not able to find an eigenvectors. Most probably we get the vector 0 0, which is looking like an absurd thing. That's why I think that somewhere I goes wrong. So that's how I detected the problems or the issue where I goes wrong. So in this way you can find that. So that's the whole thing we have to do. We do not have to memorize all the things. I think you know the procedure how to solve the diagonalizable matrix. So if you not, if you find some difficulties in my lectures or to understand the topics, so please comment below, and obviously contact me in various, there is a various option to contact me, so you can contact me. And thank you for watching. I hope you will come back in my next video.